So imagine now you're doing a very complex shoot. Everything's in place. So if you move from one light to the other, you adjust it, come back to your camera. What you saw when you were adjusting the light is not necessarily what you will see when you're behind the camera. It's very difficult to be behind the camera and adjusting all the lights at the same time. What I do is I set all my lights in the positions I think are best. I focus my lights and adjust them for position and angle. And then I go behind my camera. And because they're all connected into a DMX multiplex, I can now adjust them separately, one by one, and decide the balance between the key light, the fill light, the effect light, and the backlight, and any of the punctual lights that I set as accents on my set. So how does this work? The controller has an output of 3 or 5 pins. I'm using 5 pins here, and I'm going to set a cable in my controller, and that cable is going to go to my first light. Then I will press the 2 buttons on my light to access the program and give it an address. A digital address would be 001, for instance, if I give to my light the address 001. Then I will be able to adjust my light with the dimmer number 1. If I have a simple tungsten light, it will simply take 1 controller. If I have a bicolor light, it will absorb 2 controllers, 1 for the color and 1 for the intensity. If I don't have a DMX on my lights, you can get an accessory that attaches behind the villainy and that gives you access to a DMX control. Because I have a controller of 12 dimmers, does not mean I'm limited to 12 lights. I can use as many lights as I want. For instance, I could set 4 lights on control number 001. If all my 4 lights are set at 001, my controller 1 will access all 4 lights at the same time. If I want them to be separate, I will have to use 4 separate controls. So 1 is going to be 001, and then 02, 03, and 04. If they're bicolor, they will absorb more controls. And then the first light will be connected with the same kind of cable to the second light, and the second light to the third light, and the third to the fourth light, and so on. You then create a network of lights. You can set as many lights as you want on 1 control, as long as the address are properly set on the lights. The idea here is to have a continuous, uninterrupted strand. Now each light is going to have an address, and the address is going to correspond to 1 of the controls. Therefore, you'll be able, from behind the camera, to control all my lights using a controller, which is going to save me a lot of time. Imagine that I'm behind my camera or in front of my camera, and all my lights are connected to the controller. I can now decide the amount of key light, the amount of fill light, the amount of backlight, and the effect and accent light that I want on an object simply by dimming from the single position of where I'm shooting. Now, if I'm shooting and I need a light change during the action from the position of the camera, I can instantly see the effect that my light has on the product or on my subject. This is really studio lighting at its best. Didolite has a whole series of studio versions which all have DMX controls on them. So there you have it, perfect control of your shot, easy to use, from behind your monitor. Extraordinary capacities to make fine-tuning very accessible right at the moment you're ready to shoot. It's a great advantage. I recommend it.